is gonna be very easy. We're just doing focus group. I'm gonna ask you what's gonna sound like way too many questions of New York City.
So for the first one, it's none of us. We called in one of our friends.
Describe a typical New York City apartment.
They're usually small.
Here we go.
Little light.
Oh, and it's Explorer. Right. It's Casey.
If you do have a window, usually you can reach through and.
Kyo is a huge Elvis fan.
Building next to you. The bathroom is always the kitchen.
You're an Elvis fan?
Yeah.
This is our friend Sean Clutch, the country's premier Elvis tribute artist.
All right, what is your favorite season in New York City between the fall in New York and the fall in Virginia?
Yeah, I mean, I like it because the weather's cooler, so it's not quite as hot as the summer.
Right.
Baseball's still going on.
Nothing in the hat.
Games.
What team are you a fan of?
Yankees.
Oh, Yankees.
Yeah.
Me too.
It's just more enjoyable to be outside, but you can still go, like, upstairs.
Ta-da!
He made vomit appear!
Okay,
Joey, this one's gonna kill him.
Get ready for
this one's gonna get him.
What is your favorite restaurant in New York?
I don't know.
I'll tell you what, give me three restaurants that you like and recommend.
Oh, the ballerina! Okay.
I would say,
Sorry, the restaurants?
Via Carota in the West Village.
Via Carota?
Aqua Grill.
That's a lamp.
Aqua Grill.
And. What?
I thought I saw a bug.
Joseph, that's a sensible, nice blazer.
Doesn't fit me anymore.
Can't tell from here. You're looking good.
It's because I'm sitting down and I cut the back off it.
Here we go.
So everybody's here for focus groups, right?
Yes.
So we're just gonna call out some names. You hear your name, you just come up and then we'll send you into the appropriate room. Glagadine Capiche. Glagadine Capiche. Minty Hummer.
Minty Hummer.
Minty. Nope. Church Pew Pew Pew. Church Pew Pew Pew. Cooley Whistles. Cooley Whistles. Lumpy Dumper. Lumpy Dumper, no. Must be the 415. this is a mouthful, this one. Fiddle Roll Yolanda Smacking a Montititty Boost is the third. Maybe the third's a typo. Fiddle Roll Yolanda Smacking a Montititty Boost is the second.
That's a laugh.
I don't care.
That's a laugh.
This fat bitch. This fat bitch.
I'm just gonna hold you right now.
Here we go.
Hold me up. Hold me up. Hold me up.
Uncle Boobs. Uncle Boobs.
Come on in, I'll show you the place. Lived here for a few years.
So Murray's up. There is a reason that Joe is not with us.
Yeah.
You'll find out.
Yeah, we want to keep you guys as surprised as Murray's going to be about Joe.
I'm leaving town for about a week, okay? So I basically need somebody to house sit. I get a lot of packages, a lot of deliveries, things like that.
Murray, you guys have to tiptoe through the whole house because of your downstairs neighbors.
One thing I ask is that the neighbors below are very testy. And if you don't mind, we just kind of tiptoe around. Just easy.
Like I said, I'm out of town. I'm going to my Caucasian club meetup.
I'm out of town for the next week. I'm going to my Caucasian club meetup. It's like a group for just whites. So, okay, so over here, just kind of easy. I gotta clean this up.
You're a psychopath.
A couple things I ask is make yourself at home, but do not disturb the board. Okay? I've been working on it for a few years now, and I intend on acting on it soon. I've been tracking a lot of the history of, you don't need to know. So this way.
Are you tiptoeing?
You don't have to do, you just tiptoe if you don't mind. Just specifically over that spot. Kitchen, bathroom is here, bedroom. This is the bedroom.
Welcome to hell. Now let's find out where Joe's been.
I gotta paint over. This is the old tent. You know what? Yeah, I mean, you know. Hold.
It's the girl from The Ring.
Oh, shit. Here, let me explain.
I don't know if I want this job, man.
I'm not gonna want this job! He's putting his shoes on! Don't even...
No, I'm gonna do one more performance in 15 minutes and I gotta pick up my kid from school.
I'm kinda confused, I don't know.
I'm a member of a horror at home fan club.
Little help.
What? Joe's stuck. You should go in there.
Little help. I'm stuck halfway through the TV.
Oh, she's stuck. Diego, give me a hand, bud, for a sec.
He's fighting it. Does he take his shoes off? Does he go back in?
No.
He's shaking his head. I love this guy.
A little bit.
Hold on. One more.
Got it. Okay, I got it.
Okay.
Okay. Like I said, 15 minutes. I gotta pick up my kid.
Well, I'll be back in a few minutes, okay? Anyways, I'm sorry. So, what do you say? Do you want the job?
Here we go.
Hey, how are you? Tony, Sal, pleasure to meet you.
You want to do this?
All right, let's get it.
Here we go.
Describe what would be a good night out in New York City for you.
I would actually compare it because I did live in D.C. for a year. So I would see the prices are, somewhat the same.
For sort of a happy hour?
Yeah.
That's a working pissing dog.
It all depends on
what
you like.
Murray.
You can easily go to regular club. I was walking around Times Square and they like...
Times Square? Smells like pee up there.
Good boy, Buttles, good boy.
Not the first time I peed on Murray. Won't be the last.
Talk to me about New York City living.
I lived in Brooklyn. The rent was pretty expensive.
A bunch of illegitimate children are all doing the double dutch.
I didn't feel like it was diverse enough, so not
that's
really
a laugh.
The price.
So guys, I got a surprise for all of you.
Let's do it.
Enjoy.
Do you have a go-to neighborhood for shopping?
This Herald Square. I feel like there's a good mixture of both. It depends on what you want. Like, there's two H&M, there's a Zara.
Gamma, like the Hulk?
The Hulk.
Should he drink it?
I guess a little bit more to like High Street, but.
All right.
You drag it.
But not as like high end as like.
Uh-oh.
Something's happening.
Uh-oh.
I hope Murr's all right.
Yeah.
You can actually find a better deal or just have your gift already delivered to this,
Is that Gary Busey? Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my Lord.
That is so, so, so true.
You just reminded me of something. Oh, my goodness. You look like a psychotic teacher who was fired even though he had tenure, and now you're coming back to put a pipe bomb in the recycling bin. You're wearing a shirt with a devil on it. Like, what are you doing?
Oh, I thought you were talking to Joe.
All right, I think Q looks too suspicious. So let's start with Joe.
What is that?
That's a duck caller.
It's a duck call.
It's hunting season, Joe.
It's so quiet out here.
Here we go. Here it is. Duck call.
Did you get shushed? No one? Okay, Q, you're up, bud. Oh, Q's got the old New Year's Eve rattle.
Party like it's 1999, bitch. Nice, Joe, nice. No stretches!
Let's see what Joe pulls out. A balloon.
A balloon!
Meaning what?
Stop, how about your breath sprung on my face?
Here we go, here we go!
God.
Here we go. What is that?
A vuvuzela.
What is that?
A vuvuzela. Joe's going for the jugular.
Welcome to study hall, guys.
No shushes.
What do you got, Joe?
Cock-a-doodle-doo. For those of you that don't know, this is an old-fashioned alarm clock.
Before we had holograms to wake us up, this is what humans used.
Stop it! Stop it! People getting pissed. No shushes.
No shushes.
Unbelievable you didn't get shushed. All right, Q, you're up, buddy. Look at this, look at this. What's he got? Pull it out, buddy. What is it?
What is it, bud? Is that an air horn?
Oh, going down the gauntlet. There's no way you're getting out of that alive, buddy.
Grab a chair, Joey. Drag it around not knowing where it goes in the restaurant.
This one goes.
Kind of like a kid dragging around his blankie.
Oh, you don't know where the chair goes? That's a joke.
They got the two here. This is a two top, though, so this is not. This is four. It's this one. No. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. Where the hell?
This one has three chairs, right?
Walk outside and down the street with it. Walk outside.
Just set the chair down, sit in the chair. Yeah, yeah. Take your shoes off. Just start massaging your feet up on your lap.
You don't care anymore. Look to your left like you just saw and go, fuck me, fuck you. Fuck me, fuck you, man. Joe, could you fall back in the chair without hurting yourself? Fuck me, fuck you. Look at this guy in the straw hat. New York City!
Oh, sorry, there you go.
Sal's our big-
big loser. Oh. So to celebrate, we're here at Gary and Crystal's wedding.
Oh, yeah. Okay, who's Gary and Crystal?
Don't worry about that, Sal. You should worry about the speech.
Yeah!
No! No, guys.
Just go out there and speak from the heart.
No, I can't.
You That's
can't,
fine. We didn't think you could, so we wrote this speech for you. Come on, go ahead. Go out there and give it a little speech. We got you all taken care of.
Now, I'd love to say me and Crystal were best friends at first sight.
Look at him. Look how nervous he is.
All right, here he goes.
Oh, my God, look at this.
There's a lot of people in that wedding, buddy.
This is not right.
What Sal doesn't know is the bride and groom are actually in on it.
Yes. But the 300 strangers in the room are a different story.
Definitely not in on it.
So we're gonna ruin this wedding.
Here it comes.
All right, buddy, next speech is all yours, pal.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Here we go, yes.
Oh. Hello, everyone.
Here we go.
I hate you guys.
You hate us? I'm sorry, you hate us?
Crystal and Gary have always been the most good people I've ever known. They have always been there for me when I needed them. They're like loyal dogs. They're like my dogs. Not mean.
Not mean?
Yeah. So it's fitting that they stood by me when things got rough. When I first met them, I used to ask Gary all the time if I could. if he could send me some pictures of Crystal in a bikini. No, I run a project where I bring pictures of all different girls in bikinis to prisoners in exchange for woodworkings. Speaking in bartending speak, I can give you this metaphor about marriage. The man is like the liquor and the woman is like the mixer. And life stirs it up and God is like the bartender.
That's right.
and the devil...
Say it.
The devil is your mother-in-law. Life's gonna play tricks on you. You'll lose your job, you'll fight, you'll go into debt, you'll get sick. So let's raise a glass.
But he's not done yet.
These two people love each other so much, I hate it.
They slowly lower down.
This isn't a Jewish wedding, but my Jewish friend, Hyman, told me that in his culture, it's important for the groom to break a glass. I'm no Jew, but I have broken a lot of glasses. But tonight, I don't mean to break the Hyman.
Next page.
Tradition.
Look at their faces.
I want to tell you guys something that my grandfather told me when I was young that gave me the chills. And it seems most fitting today. He said, Sal.
Here we go.
I shot a lot of Japs in World War II.
Oh, no.
Guys, there's no denying you're awesome together. But sometimes marriage can be like war. Don't let the Japanese get in your way.
Wow. Oh my God, they're starting to revolt.
Crystal, your beautiful inside, oh.
Here it comes.
I can't say that.
You gotta finish that speech, buddy.
Your beautiful inside and out, I should know.
Cheers. That went over well.
That was brutal, man.
Gentlemen, let's raise a glass. That was
really harsh.
You guys can take a seat wherever you like. How's everybody doing?
Moderating with our boy Chase. He's gonna be guiding the whole thing exactly where we want it to go.
The topic today is gonna be artificial intelligence. I do need a volunteer for a note taker. Yeah, okay. This notepad right here, you can just dictate into it.
Good acting. Sold it.
So the first question for today is, how would you define artificial intelligence?
It's man-made.
computerized?
I think of robotics when I think of artificial intelligence.
I think it's in many different like platforms now. We have it in our cell phones now. Like it's in a lot of stuff.
Types L.
Controllable, but then it could not be controllable.
That woman is staring at it. She's already in.
What aspects of AI do you see in everyday life?
Okay, Google, Alexa, like Nest.
What is Nest?
I think it's like a hub for like the temperature, like thermostats. Oh, okay.
You could like update it from your phone. Mm-hmm.
Like close your garage door.
Yeah, like or she's even what is it? Phone. Smoke detectors. Like they could that.
Great.
AI can be destructive in that it removes like the humanity from people. We begin to rely on things to do work for us other than people. What does that mean?
I'm just what I was gleaning from the conversation, but
wait, when did we say that? No one said that though.
What steps can be taken then to prevent an AI-related disaster?
Don't give up all the control. So like the self-driving car, I think right now it has to have a driver still in the driver's seat. I don't know if they're like.
I'm thinking about like, just like my spouse is very tech friendly. If I didn't have him, I probably would be like still in the Stone Ages.
Wow, Sal is unbreakable.
All right, Mard, let's teach this class. Your dad's a senior.
Hi, Dad.
So welcome to your father. Have a seat, your ass is about to get punished.
What?
You lost the episode, buddy, because none of us said no. So, Dad, well, I'm supposed to teach you about an iPad.
So, Dad, I'm supposed to teach you about how to use an iPad.
But instead, we're going to teach you how to use an iPhone. My iPhone.
I'm going to teach you how to use my iPhone.
So let me just hook it up to the screen here so everybody can see it. All right, there it is.
All right, just randomly scroll through the photos.
I'll take you through some of the photos on my phone. You see, there's you and I and Mom, right? The other day, right? I came over and, hey, there's me as a kid.
What happened to you?
Stop pulling up normal photos.
Yeah, Mark, you know get this. In there.
Stop right there. Oh my God, look at this. That's... Dad, did you ever imagine you would have a 40-year-old son who slept with a blankie?
Did you ever imagine that you would have a 40-year-old son who sleeps with a blankie?
Maybe a pink blankie.
Can we just go through this photo right now? He's sitting alone at home. He then coyly holds a tattered blankie to his lips, peers through it at the camera. 40-year-old man. Stop right there. What's that? Stop right there. What is this?
What is this?
That's me playing video games last night in my bath towel.
He was playing naked virtual reality.
He's looking at his son. He's so disappointed.
What are you playing that with?
You know, friends.
I like that you have company and you just zone them out with virtual reality.
Stop right there. Stop right there.
Dude, what
is going on?
The confusion your father is experiencing and the regret.
Why does he have this stuff in his phone? Let's move on to like getting in contact with people, right?
Yeah.
Words?
Can you specifically call someone that you might have met in a club for adults?
Let's see. Yeah.
Hello?
Hello? Jessica?
Yes,
this is Mara's father. And I'm trying to find out how you met him.
How did I meet him?
Yeah.
Why does it matter?
Well, because they'd like to meet you again.
Oh,
that was great.
Okay, we gotta stop. At this point, it's a punishment for Mr. Murray. Look how miserable he is. We're done, Mar. That's it. We're over. Well done, Mar.
Congratulations, well done. Buddy. You suffered enough.
You got through it.
I'm James Murray. Ramon, nice to meet you, sir. These are questions about your experience being a New Yorker, okay?
For this one, we need a prop from Murray's jacket.
What were the primary reasons that you wouldn't necessarily go to see a professional sports?
When it comes to sports, professional sports,
it's your wallet.
I'm not interested in it. Well, I gotta take that back.
That's okay, your credit card.
It'll be a good tennis match when the U.S. Open is going on.
Oh, it got declined.
Wait, for sports, I go to bed.
Oh, that's your second credit card.
Well, okay, on Sundays in the summertime. Okay, I enjoy that there. Well, okay, on Sundays in the summertime. When it comes to recreation...
Come on, that's a laugh.
Well, when it comes to recreation, is somebody behind me?
No, I'm thinking of, you know what it was? I was thinking...
He's gonna wash this.
I was gonna say, oh, it's gross. Yeah. Where were you born?
In Brooklyn. We used to play on the train.
Sure.
With the
it's a young Mark.
They used to use their locomotives there. We would be at the pizzeria. 3 blocks from the house.
The pizzeria?
Oh, no, what is happening to you?
Come on.
Then we go home, and then afterwards we come back, get together, and go to the pizzeria.
Yeah, we got him.
There was a great pizzeria called Nunzio's. We used to go there every week.
Hey, guys, have fun.
In the past decade, take me through the best New York day you've had.
It would have to be more than 10 years because...
Okay, sure. It can be any time.
It was some friends of mine from L.A. came over. Mm-hmm. We spent the whole day in the city, and we traveled. At that time, we traveled. I showed them...
You remember Ghost, right, man?
I said that we're, you know, to see. With drinks on top of the World Trade Center at the River Cafe underneath the bridge.
Oh, the River Cafe! And what was that experience like?
We had a great time.
Yeah.
We ate good, and that would have been my best experience of New York City.
Off me, yes.
Yeah.
There he goes. That's a laugh.
I did not do well.
Okay, so this is my outfit.
Yeah, Joey, we put you in a breakaway basketball warm-up suit. So as soon as the person comes in, you just get ready for game time.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
Big
how are you? Nice to see you. Emily, nice to meet you.
Goodness, nice to meet you. Yeah, I'm ready to do this.
Oh, hey, man. That's amazing.
Right.
That is awesome. So nice to meet you. I'm Emily. I'm the building security manager.
Building security manager?
Yes, sir.
So and what was your name again? I'm sorry?
Emily. Yes, sir. I'm going to let you get started.
Okay,
other than that amazing intro.
Oh, thank you.
So, Joe, where are you from? Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Nah.
I didn't really want to get into that.
What's that? Which part?
My past. My shadowy past.
I didn't really want to start.
Keep saying off the record.
Off the record.
Mm-hmm.
I negotiated prices for like bulk supplies.
Mm-hmm.
I would let them in on the through the side.
Joe, she's writing this down. It's off the record.
Yeah, but this is all off the record.
No, you're fine. I'm just talking about your extensive knowledge with.
Got it. What else can I tell you off the record?
Joe, have a roving finger.
There was one time when a whole crew was in here and they had to actually be on the other side of the campus, but the middle was closed, so I couldn't get them through. We had to actually go around the whole thing.
But off the record.
Off the record, Monica.
Off the record. We went through the closed road, Monica.
Here comes the roving finger.
And, you know, there was a lot of teams up here, and then we brought it down south. You know, we connect everybody, and they all had their little conferences and stuff, and so we did the whole thing. But I have to
stop. Excuse yourself for one quick moment to go to the bathroom and then go downstairs and play basketball.
I'm gonna use the restroom real quick. I'm sorry.
Yeah, sure, no worries.
I'll be right back. I'll be right back. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Thanks.
Look at her face! This is gonna be
her
amazing.
Face is.
Joe, security really sucks around here.
You good?
Yeah, security really sucks. I was able just to go down there and shoot hoops. So security's an issue. Security's an issue.
And, well, do you have any further questions for me?
You'll be in touch, and she did great.
And that's it. Yeah, thank you so much.
You did great.
We'll be in touch.
Yeah. I'll get Jakeem to
Hey, appreciate it. Yeah, we'll let you know. Possibly, maybe we'll hire her. I'm not sure if we'll hire her.